नमस्कार ವೀಕ್ಷಕರೇ ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಮ ರಕ್ಷಿತ್ ರಾಜ್ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ 2 ಓಕೆ ಗೈಸ್ ದಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ನಂಬರ್ 8 ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಫಾಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರೆಸ್ ರೋಶನಿ ಎ ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟ್ ಹರ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಅಸೆಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಯರ್ 2019-20 ದಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಶಿ ಗೇವ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಕನ್ಸಲ್ಟೆನ್ಸಿ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೆನರ್ಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಇಯರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ರೂಪೀಸ್ 55,000 ಫ್ರಮ್ ಕ್ಲೈಂಟ್ಸ್ Out of that, she claims she had spent rupees 5,000 on related traveling. Next, income from agriculture in Sri Lanka rupees 20,000, dividend from UTI rupees 5,000, interest on post office savings bank account rupees 1,000. She holds the following investments. They are rupees 1,09,000 tax free commercial securities, which is not listed. Rupees 30,007% debentures of Rice Mill Limited. 72,000 10% tax free debentures of LIC India, which is listed. And last point is she lives in a rented house and pays her rent of rupees 6,000 per month, where she has sublet 1/3 portion of the house on a rent of rupees 3,000 per month. She has taken up the responsibility of paying municipal taxes of rupees 1,500 on which whole house and also repairs of the whole house amounting to rupees 6,000. So problem number 8 nodana, that is previous year is 18-19, assessment year is 19-20 and assessee is Mistress Roshini. So calculate the income from other source, particulars to amount columns. First point in it is management consultancy services. Can be treated as professional incomes, but she is not a regular professional. Adukoskar other sources thagondidivi. That is 55,000, but she claimed some traveling expenses for receiving that income. That is traveling expenses 5,000. So if we deduct 5,000 from 55, it will be 50,000. And next income from agriculture in Sri Lanka. So anything which is outside India, so agriculture in other outside India there. Fully taxable, that is 20,000. Dividend from UTI, always exempted. Interest on post office savings bank up to 5,000. Sorry, up to 3,500. So up to 3,500 it is exempted. So in our summary list, what is it is given as 1,000. So it is less than 3,500. Exempted. Next, that is interest on tax free commercial securities. So only tax free commercial securities are there. Interest kodli athwa investment plus interest rate kodli. So irrespective of them, we have to calculate the TDS. Okay. So only 1 lakh is the principal amount and into 9%, that is 9,000 is the interest. So e interest well again we have to calculate the TDS, grossing up monthly, that is 9,000 into 100 divided by 100 minus 10. So interest again out 10% TDS and 3 divided. So 100 minus 10 is 100 by 90. That is 10,000. Next, interest on debentures of Rice Mill Limited. So Rice Mill is a private limited. So anything which is private, it is a commercial securities, tax free na less tax akotilla. So we are going to assume it as less tax commercial securities. Again, only two situations baruthe. That is whether namge interest kotidara illa now interest kandidivella. Interest kotidre we have to gross up. So interest kotilla andre now interest en kandidtivi outer column direct barkontivi TDS madala. So namge principal amount and interest rate kodidare direct kodilla, so we have to find out the interest. That is 30,000 into 7%, 2,100. So illi namge grossing up concept parala. Next, interest on tax free debentures of LIC of India. So LIC of India nan helidre it is a company. So company andre it is commercial securities. So illi tax free commercial securities agutte. So tax free commercial securities anta andaga principal amount into interest rate. So the investment amount is 72,000 into 10% is the interest, that is 7,200 will be interest. So e interest mele now grossing up madthivi, that is 7,200 into 100 divided by 100 minus 10, that is nothing but 90. So it is 8,000. Okay. So the next point is income from subletting. So subletting is only 1/3 of the portion. E 1/3 ke eshtu receive madthidare 3,000 per month. So 3,000 into 12. ಟೋಟಲ್ ಅವ್ರ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬರ್ತದೆ ಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರೆಸ್ ರೋಷನಿಗೆ, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ 36,000. ಆ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇರೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಅವ್ರು ಏನೇನು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸ್ ಬೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕ್ಲೈಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಡಿಡಕ್ಷನ್. ಯಾವುದು ರೆಂಟ್ ಪೇಡ್ ಟು ದಿ ಆಕ್ಚುಯಲ್ ಓನರ್ ಇಸ್ 6,000 ಪರ್ ಮಂತ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಂಟು 12 ಇಂಟು ಅವ್ರು ಕ್ಲೇಮ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿರೋದು, ಕ್ಲೇಮ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಆಗೋದು ಓನ್ಲಿ
1/3 portion because our income towards the 36,000 for 1/3 adakke en expense aagutade adanna matra avaru deduct maadabodu okay that is 24,000 again less municipal tax so overall house ge rest pay maartidare 1500 adenu per month anta kottilla so 1500 as it is tagontira into 1/3 portion ge eshtu tax kartidare adanna matra claim maadabodu that is 1500 into 1/3 is 500 next again same like municipal tax repairs kuda maartidare that is 6000 into 1/3 so 6000 into 1/3 is 2000 so the 36000 minus 24 minus 500 minus 2000 that is 9500 so total of outer column is 99600 is called as income from other sources income from other sources okay guys the next problem is problem number 9 so ee problem in include agide this is all about gift so gift mail kuda one 6 mark sums kodabodu anno example koskara ee problems martta idini so problem number 9 related to gift okay so ni now problem nodtane sum madkon hogana so solution enide problem 9 previous year is 1890 assessment year is 1920 and assess is mistress sheila and calculation of income from other sources particulars and amount column so the particulars andaga first point en heltidare mr sheila gets by gift a commercial flat from the elder brother of her father in law the stamp duty value is rupees 1,50,000 so illen heltidare gift from gift as commercial flat athwa gift of commercial flat receive maartidare yarinda from elder brother of his father in law so it is a non relative indirect relative aagtare so anything which is received from indirect relative or non relative andre exceeding 50,000 is taxable as well as any stamp duty value kottidare again stamp duty value more than 50,000 idre complete amount is taxable ill list kottidare it is 1,50,000 so more than 50,000 idre complete amount is taxable summer kottiradu 1,50,000 outer column anta hottira next second point she receives a house property and a will from a non relative the stamp duty value is 5,00,000 so there is a gift under a will from non relative illi will anta bandaga inherited anta bandaga athwa trust inda bartade anta helidre then ali direct relative agli indirect relative agli friend agli then it is complete amount is exempted so under a will bartarodrinda eshte amount idru it is exempted okay next point is she gets by way of gift a land stamp duty value is 1,80,000 from a partnership firm the firm has only two partners that is father of sheila avara tande and brother of sundar so who is sundar here sundar is sheila's husband so andre avara tande mattu avara gandana anna kadeinda gift bartade so aadre illi partnership anta bandaga it is treated as non relative so non relative andre anything which is exceeding 50,000 it should be taxable so the stamp duty value is kodidare it is 1,80,000 so more than 50,000 idre it is complete amount is taxable outer column alli full amount tagondira okay next point nodana that is she gets a land by way of gift from a cousin of sundar stamp duty value is 45,000 so the cousin of sundar is a non relative aagtare aadre stamp duty value eshtu ide illi namge gift of land stamp duty value eshtu ide it is less than 50,000 eshtu ide 45,000 ide so less than 50 idre it is exempted okay next point is she receives a shop by way of gift from friend stamp duty value is 40,000 again gift of shop from her friend so friend aadre more than 50 idre taxable again stamp duty value is kodidara it is less than 50,000 so less than 50 is there 40,000 ide so 40,000 ginta 50,000 ginta jaasti idre matra taxable agutte so below 50,000 idre it is exempted cash gift of rupees 6000 from the elder brother of her grandfather so elder brother of grandfather is a non relative aagtare so yen gift sigtade avarge cash gift from non relative that is less than 50,000 ishtide 6,000 ide so less than 50 idre it is exempted okay next point is
On the occasion of marriage, she gets rupees 1 lakh as gift, out of which 60,000 is received from her friend and the balance amount is received from the relatives. So the relatives in the event 40,000 balance andre out of 1 lakh 60,000 is from friend and 40,000 is from relative. So relative adre este amount idru it is exempted. Friend adre athwa any non-relative adre up to 50,000 tax exemption. More than 50,000 adre complete amount taxable anta helidivi. So illi en helthidare gift on the occasion of marriage. So on the occasion of marriage adre whether it could be received from relative, non-relative or a friend or colleague or some other person anta andre kuda occasion of marriage adre este amount adru it is exempted. Okay, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅಕೇಶನ್ ನಾಪ್ ಕಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಅಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾರೇಜ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಆ ಟೈಮ್, ಏನ್ ಮದುವೆ ಟೈಮ್ ಇದೆ ಆ ಟೈಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಎಕ್ಸೆಂಪ್ಷನ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಶಿ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಗಿಫ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 60,000 ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಕಸಿನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಫಾದರ್. ಸೊ ಕಸಿನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ನಾನ್ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್. ಸೊ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಗಿಫ್ಟ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಸಿಗ್ತದೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ? ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಗಿಫ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ನಾನ್ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ 50,000, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ 60,000 ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಬಲ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅಗೇನ್ she gets a cash gift of rupees 60,000 from the elder brother of her grandmother. So her grandmother or her elder brother is a non relative, she is not a direct relative. So that is why cash gift from non relative is more than 50,000 is andre eshtide 60,000. So more than 50,000 complete amount is taxable, that is 60,000. Next, the last point is cash gift of rupees 80,000 from grandmother and rupees 1,50,000 from grandfather. So ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದಾರೆ, ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಗಿಫ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮದರ್. ಸೊ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್. ಸೊ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟೇ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಇದ್ರು ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಂಪ್ಟೆಡ್. ಅಗೇನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಗಿಫ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಫಾದರ್, ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್. ಸೊ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಅಗೇನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಎಕ್ಸೆಂಪ್ಟೆಡ್. ಸೊ ನೌ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಸ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಸೋರ್ಸಸ್. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಗಿಫ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕೊಟ್ಟಾಗ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಏನ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಗೇಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇದೆ, ಅಗೇನ್ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಏನ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಗೇಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಟೋಟಲ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಏನಿದೆ, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ 1,50,000, 1,80,000, 60,000 and 60,000, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ 4,50,000. ಈ ಅಗ್ರಿಗೇಟ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಏನಿದೆ, ದಟ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸೀಡ್ 50,000. ಎಕ್ಸೀಡ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಬಲ್. ಇದೇನಾದ್ರೂ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಅಪ್ ಟು 50,000 ಅಥವಾ ಬಿಲೋ 50,000 ಇತ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ದಿಸ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅಗೇನ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಂಪ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಕ್ಲೇಮ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ವಿ. ಬಟ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಅಗ್ರಿಗೇಟ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ 50,000 ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ದಿ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ 50,000 ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೈ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟ್ರೀಟೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಅದರ್ ಸೋರ್ಸಸ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಸೋರ್ಸಸ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ವೈಂಡ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ 7 ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ 10 ನ ಟೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅಸೈನ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಇನ್ನ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಡೌಟ್ಸ್ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಬಂತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗಿವ್ ಎ ಕಮೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಕಮೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್, ಆರ್ ಎಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮೀ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡೆಡ್ ಇಮೇಲ್ ಐಡಿ. ಸೊ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ನೋಟ್ಸ್, ಥಿಯರಿ ನೋಟ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ನೋಟ್ಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಷನ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಲಿಂಕ್ ಇದೆ. ಆ ಲಿಂಕ್ ನ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದಿ PDF ನೋಟ್ಸ್. ನೀವಿನ್ನು ನನ್ನ ಚಾನಲ್ ಗೆ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ಕೂಡಲೇ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಆಗಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ನೋಟಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ಗಾಗಿ ಬೆಲ್ ಐಕಾನ್ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಜೈ ಹಿಂದ್, ಜೈ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ.